Welcome back to Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Liquid Audio, Church and Classic Audio. And here we have a classic and venerable Marantz CD-12. They didn't call it a CD player back then. They called it a compact disc drive. Isn't that just hilarious? But these really are beautiful. These use a beautiful old school Philips swing arm mechanism. These lasers are just fantastic. And this whole mech is absolutely superb. The downside, it's very serviceable as a mech. It's extremely serviceable. This one is dry as a bone. It needs greasing, lubing. Every pivot point needs oil. But the downside is it uses four belts, and it's a pain in the ass to fit all these belts. It really is. But here I have a set of belts, and I'm going to fit a set of belts for my customer. Painful job, but we're going to do it. Okay, so we're back here with this CD-12. I've changed this first belt on the inside. Now I've got to change this belt to change that belt. It's a real pain in the bum, so we'll do that one last. Now I'm doing these couple. I'm going to grease and lube these shafts as well, and then I'm going to change that inner belt while I've got this thing out. I'll clean this of grease and re-grease it. So yeah, getting there. Have to remove the limit switches there as well, but anyway, all part of the fun. Of course, that when you are changing belts, doing this kind of work, you need proper belt tweezers. You can see I have a pair of tweezers here that are specially shaped for holding belts, and it's just the only way to do it. The only way you can kind of hold the belt properly and loop it over where you need to loop it is to use these belt tweezers. So it's tedious work, but this is a little tool that makes the job just a little bit easier. Right, this part is the hardest part, and it's changing this belt, which is the inside belt that controls the loader. And how you have to do it is you have to remove this little C-clip actually, and take the wheel off the shaft without disturbing the arrangement of the wires on the pulley. But it just requires a little bit of finessing. And so we have it in place, then that's the new belt there, and I'm just about to do up this C-clip, so yeah. And so there they are, those are the four original belts that came out of this machine. They are pretty worn. I mean, they're not actually too bad. We could have used these, but they were a bit stretched. I did in fact get the mechanism working really well with these old belts in place, but the customer wanted new belts. And so we have new belts there, two belts on that side, two belts on that side. Right, welcome back. So here we are with the lovely Marantz CD-12. Compact disc drive, aka CD player, and it's had a full service, gone through and done a full mechanical service, replaced all of the drive belts, which are here. You can see them there. Those are the old drive belts. There are four, but critically, I've also lubricated the entire mechanism, and that means every pulley, every motor, the sled itself, all of these things have been lubed, so that now, look at that. Beautiful. It's very smooth. It's pretty quiet. It's about as quiet as these things get. It says disc error because there's no disc. So let's pop a disc in and see. There we go. Whoops. Should read the table of contents, and there it is. Sorry, I just got interrupted there, but yeah, so you can see it reads the table of contents very quickly. I'll just do that again. So we open it up, there is a disc in there. It's my Coldplay disc, which I use for testing. Close it up and let's have a look. There, bang, it's super fast to read the table of contents. Hit play, she plays nicely, off she goes. So, I mean, this is as close to perfect as one can get, really a very good result. But it highlights the need to do more than just, like, you can't just change these belts. Changing the belts is one thing, but that won't fix the problem. In fact, this the whole tray was very stiff until I'd lubricated every roller, every pulley, all the parts of that wire drive that have to be lubed. So you've got to do those little things. When you do all those things, you get a very good result like this. I also clean the laser optics. That's important. You have to make sure that that's all good. I didn't go as far as to test the laser current because in this case, the machine works so well that I thought probably leave it. You know, it's working so well. I don't want to tempt fate and do anything that could cause a problem. So the machine works beautifully. I think the owner will be very happy, and that's a Marantz CD-12. Beautiful machine, very, very heavy build, lovely construction. And this one,
lives on.
So if you'd like me to service your CD-12 or any other Marantz CD player for that matter, CD-94, CD-63, CD-67, whatever it might be, I'd be very happy to do so. You can contact me, Mike, at Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. That's Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Liquid Audio, cherishing classic audio. Thanks. Bye.